This is a female patient, 24 years old, with history of recent marriage, about 1 week. Patient gave history of primary amenorrhea. This means that she has no history of any menstruation after puberty in her life. TVS is totally failed because the TVS probe is not passed through the vaginal cavity. Now the abdominal scan is done with full distended bladder. You can see a small uterus. Size of the uterus is 34 mm and AP width is 7.8 mm. Endometrium is grossly thinned. Now this is very small uterus. The normal size of the uterus is 6 cm. This is a case of hypoplastic uterus. Hypoplastic uterus is a congenital abnormality of uterus. We can see the vaginal cavity in continuity with the uterus. A thin line of vaginal cavity is visualized in the whole length of the vagina. So this is case of vaginal stenosis or vaginal atresia. Stenosis or atresia cannot be differentiated in ultrasound alone. Stenosis is narrowing and atresia is closed or absent vaginal cavity. Absent vagina can be seen on ultrasound. These are the serious causes of congenital infertility. Both ovaries of patient is visualized and are of good size. Right ovary is 32 mm and has 8 mm follicle. Left ovary is 28 mm and has 6 mm follicle. Now the most important question is, in this recently married patient, is there any treatment? Now the first of all, there are vaginal surgeries so that the patient can have normal sexual contact with her husband. Although most of the hypoplastic uterus patients don't get pregnancy, but there are some chances. Patient should have given hormonal medicines so the uterus size increases with the medicines. Also, there can be menstruation with the effect of the medicines. In this case, the ovaries are normal and follicles can develop. So in some patients, IVF can be successful. So this can be a long, expensive treatment with hormones and IVF and surgery with some chances of pregnancies. Even if patient cannot afford IVF treatment, she must have given the hormonal medicines so that she have some menstruation with the effect of medicines. Otherwise, the patient can develop bone osteoporosis much earlier in her life. There may be associated renal abnormalities, but kidneys was normal in this case.